Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Swiss Dota 2 Championships, the semi-finals between Rono Gaming and the Hornet Mena. My name is Morality Claws and I'm joined today by Zach Owen. How are you doing?
It's going good.
5 seconds.
Very good, very good.
Very pumped for today's match.
Yes, for one of them with a name you can't pronounce.
Die Honigamena.
Right. Well then, yeah, close enough.
Close enough, there we go.
Die, Hornigman. No, right, yeah, that's pretty good.
What does it mean?
The actually is the Honeymen.
The Honeymen.
The Honeymen.
Oh, what a name.
What a name.
And looking at the bans, quite popular bans recently.
Ah yes, the Queen of Pain has been banned out, meaning you won't get salty this match.
No, my salt levels are on the low. Perfect.
So, Leshrac as well is being a popular ban simply because of his magical damage.
Yeah, Leshrac'd.
In the early game, and in the mid game as well, he can dish out some pretty heavy nukes.
And he's the person who doesn't give a crap about towers either.
Just gonna push, and I'll
care. No matter what.
Undying is banned out next, pretty good ban as well.
Yeah, I reckon these four heroes that they've banned out, both teams sort of agree, yeah, let's ban them all out, they're all a bit crap.
And now a gyrocopter, so the main carry has been picked for Rhino. Well, actually they could play mid, I've seen a mid gyro.
Yeah, I've seen support gyro.
It's weird, it's very weird, but you know, it could work.
Yeah, I see, Virtus Polar, they do it a lot. Is it Virtus Polar at the moment?
I think it's Virtus Pro at the moment.
Oh, Virtus Pro, there we go.
They switch around a lot.
Aces Polar, wasn't it? Yeah.
Yeah, they switch around a lot for some reason. Earthshake has picked up, very good pickup considering it's a very versatile support.
Yep, and also can go mid.
Oh yeah, you got a point there.
Yeah.
The Crit Shaker. The Crit Shaker.
Oh yeah.
What can you do about that? Well, actually you can do a lot because Crit Shaker, if you don't get a good start, just ends up falling off quickly.
Reserve time. It's going to be quite rare that we actually see a Crit Shaker, probably just the position for babysitting Earthshaker.
You know, standard Earthshaker.
Standard Earthshaker, yeah. And Earthshaker fares pretty well against Gyrocopter, apart from when that Rocket Barrage hits him in the face. Earthshaker doesn't like that at all.
It is a Witch Doctor, though.
Witch Doctor. Witch Doctor, am I?
Illusion Rune. Anyway, it also is a very good pit fight combo. You have to think, like, the Roshan will not be easy to take if the Hornet Mena know that the enemy team is taking Roshan.
Ooh, I reckon an Alchemist. Radiant.
Maybe.
Maybe not now that they picked up the AA.
No, not really.
But you know what? An Alchemist could be fun. If the Witch Doctor an early ward, be really good. Early ward? Early Alchemist.
That was like thinking like what? I'm thinking you mean the death. I thought you meant the death ward there. Like, why would you give Witch Doctor a death ward?
Yeah.
Anyway, but this AA like. It doesn't. It gets picked up on and off. It's just that hero, you know. It's just that hero.
Yeah, it's just that hero in general.
I mean, especially combined with the gyro, you have cold feet. You have the ice vortex. You can combine pretty well with the gyro.
Yeah, no one wants cold feet.
Ah yes, great puns coming out from the Swiss DC crew here.
Just wear socks. That's my advice, boys. And girls, if there are any girls watching, but I think, I'm not sure, I think the majority of people who watch Professional Dota are men, right?
I would assume so too.
Yeah, there's probably some secret females somewhere hiding in the dark depths of Dota 2.
dark depths. AKA Shiva.
Yep, Shiva. If Shiva's watching, hello.
10 seconds.
You can have my bottle charges.
I think Admiral Bulldog has something to say about that. Anyway.
Yeah, Admiral Bulldog.
Jesus. Slug Band. Now, what do you say about that?
Very popular last meta.
10 seconds.
Like 6.8 something. The last patch before this one, Slark was really popular as well. I think he's really fallen off because Slark's really good against like single pickoff, and then recently we've seen the meta change significantly into more of a team fight oriented sort of thing. Slark's really dropped off, in my opinion.
It's like it's sort of in between though. It's like team fights oriented and single pickoff at the same time.
Yeah.
It's like it's one of both, and you want heroes that can do both. For example, a Zeus.
Yep, Zeus. Push and single pickoff and great team fight potential.
I mean, if you can drop the, you can drop all your spells there. You have the static field. You also have like the Thunder God's Wrath, which is an obvious thing. But you can also be like single pickoff. You can go roaming with Zeus, lightning bolts, and arc lightning, and once again Thunder God's Wrath. And you can just go around killing people, really.
Yeah, you can.
10 seconds to go.
Ugh.
So yeah,
sorry
so
about that.
Not bad, not bad at all.
Yeah, and Viper's been banned out, main reason. Reserve time. They have a lot of magic damage on the side of the Radiant, and Corrosive Skin's just very strong.
Of course. Windranger has picked on Rhino Gamer, which is interesting to say the least. Windrun doesn't really work against the team that Hornig Mena have right now.
Maybe that high magic damage, like Windranger is particularly squishy. And
that's what I mean. It's like Windrun doesn't do anything right now. It's like oh great, it's giving me max movement speed. What if I get Fisher blocked? Oh, here's the cast bounce coming in. Zeus is just gonna nuke me to death. That's not gonna work in your favor.
5 seconds. No, not at all, really. Maybe Windranger just goes mid and just trades farm with the Zeus. I believe Zeus is going mid. Like, I think that's probably the best bet for Rhino.
Could be, yeah.
Yeah, we're not. I reckon a Rubick would be so strong for Rhino.
Oh yeah, especially with the Echo Slam or just, you know, just stealing anything from Witchdoctor
and the
or
the Northfield.
Oh yeah.
And I'd just give them a bit. Why would you pick Phoenix into Windranger? Focus Fire the Egg, can you still do that?
I'm not sure, to be honest.
You Focus Fire the Egg, that's like 2 seconds and they're dead. Maybe they just think the stun lock on the Earthshaker and the Witch Doctor should be enough to keep the Windranger at bay.
But will it, is the question.
Probably not.
I mean, if the Windranger, remember, even if she is on her own, this is two pro teams we're talking about. Rotations are going to be there. Oh, and Rubick. They did pick up a Rubick. Nice prediction from you there.
I'm just too good.
You're on a roll.
I am on a roll today, actually. I've predicted a Magnus and a Rubick. And I love playing Rubick.
Rubick is really fun, yeah.
Yeah, especially with the cliff. 10 seconds. Put people on the cliff, that's always quite funny.
So, yeah, this Rubick will definitely work in their favour. Being able to steal anything from Team Hornig Mener is already good.
Yep.
Except maybe Witch Doctor Restoration. That's it.
Yeah, that's the main thing.
Enchant Totem, though, is like, you have to remember, he's arranged. He's ranged, Rubick is. And if he gets a 400% damage, it's basically like an extra nuke for him.
Yeah, it's just an extra nuke, and I'm not sure if the Rubick will be building into the Daedalus and the Divine Rapier you were thinking of, but it all helps. It all helps.
Radiant's pit. Of course, standard Rubick build. I mean, it's carry Rubick. It's the only Rubick.
Oh, of course. It's the only Rubick in the world.
Jesus.
Like, safe lane, you just last hit with Fade Bolt. What else do you want? Is it Fade Bolt?
Yeah, Fade Bolt.
Yeah, Fade Bolt. Just last hit with Fade Bolt. Harass them out.
And yes, run out of mana 2 minutes into the game.
Yeah, and the Weaver's been banned out, as well as the Puck.
Weaver ban out is pretty good. I mean, an offlaner, although they have an offlaner. They have the offlaner in form of a Windranger. She could also go mid, though.
Yeah, and Weaver naturally gets that MKB as well, so it'd be pretty good against Windranger, and also quite slippery, so gets away from Rubick in AA.
Mm-hmm. Ah, Spectra. Ooh.
Ooh, that's a fun hero to cast.
Yes. Now, it depends on what Spectra does. There's been the early fighting build, which has been rotating around pubs, which involves building a mom. Kind of fell off after the last patches, I believe.
I reckon Mask of Madness, Drum, Yasha, maybe Diffusal Blade somewhere. I think that'd probably be the build for Spectre with BKB late game.
What else you can do is you can see how much farm you get in the early game. See if you can like really get the lanes, and if you can't, then you go the early fighting build. But if you can, then just go the Radiant and go more of a farming slow build.
Reserve. Yeah, that's a good point.
So it's like, you get the farming build, of course, you're going to be online like way later, but what it does give you is gives you the advantage of that when you come online, you will be completely unstoppable.
Yep.
Especially since Radiance now gives you a mischance.
Yeah, it does. Okay, last pick. I reckon they need an offlane, they need a bit of beef. Bristleback's been banned out. Centaur couldn't be that good. They need a natural pipe builder.
I mean, Centaur could be good, yeah.
Yeah, I reckon.
No, they go silent.
I didn't reckon that.
No, not really. But it works. It definitely works. If you can time the global silence correctly, the entire team of Hornig Men is suddenly stuck.
Yeah. They have a lot of. They are very spell dependent.
So we'll see what both these teams come up with then. What strats we will be seeing.
What's with all the scribbling? Hacksaw, that's an off-flame Windranger. I reckon that would be a mid-silencer.
Against Zeus.
I think that works. I think silencer
wins that. Kotz does nothing though. Curse of the Silence does nothing though. I mean, Zeus just does chain lightning as he usually would, and that's it. Kotz gone.
I think the mana burn is probably the main thing. That Q silencer. What's the Q ability?
Yeah, that's
called?
The Curse of the Silence.
Oh, Curse of the Silence. Yeah, sorry.
Yeah, that's the thing though. He's just gonna. Zeus is able to purge that off without any problems. Considering that chain lightning is very spammable.
Yeah, I guess so. Oh, they're switching around now. They're swapping heroes. Okay, maybe not, hey. So, I'll do Rhino.
You wanna. Okay.
And on Rhino, we have Hacksaw playing the Rubick. We have Fimo on the Ancient Apparition. We have Don't You Know I'm Loco on that silencer. Fucking some really good cosmetics there. We have Wolverate playing the Gyrocopter. And friend of mine, Arkosh on the win.
Alright then, and on team Hornig Manor, we have Failed Jzzg playing Spectre. We have Residuenzatz, aka Tino, playing Zeus. We have LC playing Phoenix. We have Cola Light playing Witch Doctor. And we have Edoism playing Upshake. And there seems to be some trash talking before this first engagement. Hacksaw looks like he's in a bit of trouble. In fact, Hacksaw might actually die. Good shackle by Arkosh, but Hacksaw will still feed First Blood here. Loco might be the next one to fall. In fact, Loco actually gets Phoenix.
Oh, don't you know I'm Loco? There's going to be a Spectral Dagger.
Oh no, Arkosh is blocked off. In fact, Silencer takes a fall, and Arkosh will probably take a fall here as well, as he is stuck in a very bad spot. What? Spectre actually dies first. Now, Cola Light seems to be next on the agenda.
Okay, indeed.
I'm not sure what to say. This fight was everywhere. Three deaths Fimo's on the side of Rhino. Fimo's in trouble. Fimo will be the next one to fall. In fact, Akosh now. Perfect shackle from Arkosh and Cola Light. Will he get it? No. Nice Fisher block.
Oh my god. It's absolute shit.
I don't know who won that, to be honest.
Oh, this is...
I'm unsure who won that. It's four deaths for Rhino, 4-2. It's like 1,000 gold lead for UAE, but 500, only 500 gold swing, so it's still recoverable. And they're going for a more aggressive tri lane on the bot lane.
Yeah, I think that's understandable. They have a lot of lockdown and that cold feet and chilling touch definitely could get them a few kills.
Well, let's see though. Oh, they also have the lift, remember? They have the lift, they have shackle, they have a lot of ways to secure the cold feet.
Yeah, and it's only a Spectre. Spectre won't find any farm here.
a fail just is. I'm not. I'm actually unsure. I'm just gonna call them fail. Jizzig.
Edoism is sort of just stacking and pulling. That's probably the best way.
You know what? His Fisher blocks were on point throughout that entire first few minutes of engagement.
Yeah, he did write easy Fisher.
It was a pretty good. That's how you should play Earthshaker. And it looks like they actually want to go in on someone here. Earthshaker is missing. Will they be able to find a target? No, Desolate's actually been leveled here. Yep, Edoism is there. In fact, they might turn it around on Arkosh now, who does not have Windrun. Will Edoism be the first to fall? Arkosh, he could have. Nice Shackle, but unfortunately, he might still die. He will still die.
Arkosh dies here.
They kill Earthshaker in return, though. My problem with that was Arkosh could have probably used Power Shell to get out of there. Oh, Residuance, that's rotates and gets Fimo. And now Haxor is probably going to fall as well. Haxor will fall.
There we go. It was a really good trade there.
You know what? I feel like Arkosh could have gotten out of that with a Power Shot.
Yeah, I think if you would have Power Shot to the east when he was fissured in, I reckon he could have got out.
Like there or even just there. Just Power Shot through and run.
Yeah, just right there. Might have been the best bet. And on the other lanes, we just have Gyrocopter just dominating CS there, and Silencer, as expected, is just owning the mid lane, too.
So yeah, Silencer even has... Yes, no, they're kind of even, though.
Yeah, I guess so.
Yes, and you are actually right.
The Silencer just came in, so... Yeah.
Silencer is doing it well. He's using the good gold COTS last word combos just to keep the Zeus from... doing much, keeping the Zeus mana drained. He has to bottle crow.
Yeah, that's a good point there. And Phoenix is not getting as much as, like, he. Phoenix is a she, right?
It's something. It's it.
It's something. It is getting something. They're two ring of protection, so like the Phoenix can battle up against a Gyrocopter, but just the magic damage from Rocket Barrage.
The thing is, Phoenix naturally will build up into a Midas.
Yeah, that's probably the best item that Phoenix can get, that early levels as well.
Make sure he can also like catch up to the to his team if he really does get zoned.
Yeah, and otherwise your egg, like at level 6, is absolutely rubbish. But when it's level 11, when you're level 11, pretty good.
Haste on the Silencer. Okay, nice cots there. Keeping him mostly mana drained. What is actually Silencer maxing? He is going last word cots, not taking level of glaives. Probably the obvious build. You don't need glaives until like level, I don't know. When do you usually get glaives?
When do I get glaives level 1?
Oh, you're one of those Silencers, eh? In fact, there's a gam coming in on Tino. Loco seems to be diving deep, but he's got a haste rune. So he probably will be able to survive unless, no, Residuensatz. Will he be able to tango through this? In fact, he will.
Arkosh on the bot lane, he's getting gone on Colonized Fisher.
Ooh, nice Fisher, nice Shackle once again, but Fimo's now blocked off. Arkosh does get a kill on the Witch Doctor, but Fail will get a kill on the AA. Oh, now it's a 1v1.
A Desolate.
Ooh, what a Shackle. Now Fail is searching for him. Does he have a Spectral Dagger? In fact, he does, but Arkosh has silenced up. Silence is up on Fail, but Edoism is there to help. Haxor does not have enough damage to stop them. And nice Fisher securing the kill on the Windranger. And Fail is just Desolate damage, pure. TP reactions coming into the Tier 2. There's a Silencer, making sure she'll be unable to do much. And there, Silence is on. Cold Feet is on, but that won't do much. However, this Chilling Touch will, and that's a kill on the Spectra.
Yeah, too deep.
Way too deep.
Who got the kill there?
Ooh, that Shackle. Almost got it on Edoism. Probably mistargeted.
Yeah, just... Well, looking at the CS still, the Dire are obviously dominating here. Spectre hasn't found a lot, like, with last hits and stuff like that.
Just kills, but, though.
Yeah, the net worth, he's definitely battling up there. It could be a lot worse.
Yeah, it could be a lot worse. Let's have a look at net worth, actually. I haven't had a look at it for Yeah, it's 2,630 for Wolverate on his gyrocopter, and 2,200 on Loco. So Dire are leading in net worth.
Yeah, quite a lot as well.
So doing pretty well.
Yeah, doing pretty well indeed, and it's only going to get worse, I think, for the Dire side. Well, actually, no, for the Radiant side, more like. Like, right now, I have an early lead in the net worth right now, but I know for a fact. Oh, there we go. Kid on the top lane. Well played by Wolverate.
Alright, yeah. Sorry, I had my microphone muted there for some reason. let me just check if everything's good. Yep. Now, okay. Do you think this is going to be a quick game or not, is my question.
Yeah. Very quick.
Yeah. Oh, Spectre looks to be in a bit of trouble. Cold Feet will be popped, but... Oh! Nice, Zeus getting a kill on the gyrocopter. Spectre will take a fall, though.
Yeah, they really turned that one around.
There's Thunder God's Wrath for you.
Yeah, that was used. I reckon, the...
Ooh, Residuans, that's... Yeah,
Residuans, the Radiant team really have to fight around the cooldowns. Like, if you have a look, all of their ultimates are big ultimates. Well, Rubick and Windranger, they're... Like... It depends, really, but they are, like, essentially based around their cooldowns.
Yeah, definitely. It's like... Really, what the Radiant can't do is that... Oh, Zeus! Not good. Wanting to get the rune. Fimo and Haxor, that's to kill him, though. In fact, Fimo now has his... Tranks. Oh, is that a good Shackle? Shackle does latch, but Shackle is not leveled, so... Only a 1.5 second Shackle.
Still a 1.5 second Shackle. Shackle is such a broken ability.
Oh, come on. You have to hit it.
Yeah, you can hit it anywhere. Hits a tree on the other side of the map. Yeah, I really do hate playing against Windranger, but I do find playing Windranger is really fun.
That is true. Being able to run away from everything, but not only that, the Shackle shots, the focus fire, it's all amazing.
It's all really fun, yeah.
Radiant's top tower is taking a hit. And Gyro will start to push through the top tower. He's actually maybe going to take it in a few seconds.
All but Venom on the Wolverine.
That's an interesting... meanwhile, engagement. Arkosh looks like to be in a bit of trouble. In fact, Arkosh will take a fall along with Haxor. Silence is out, but it's a bit too late. Now, Gyrocopter did rotate in. Spectre will not be found, but they will find Cola Light. And Cola Light will take a fall. However, Zeus is there, probably going to get Wolverine. No, Fail will come out of the jungle and take Wolverine. Or will he? Interesting, Zeus getting Wolverine there. Egg is popped. Will Fimo die to Egg? Fimo will die to Egg. And that's a 3-for-2.
Yeah, it's really scrappy right now, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. Oh, they might even lose the courier. Courier jukes are there. Though. Ooh, LC's getting lifted. Loco is there to help. Will LC die? LC will die. Oh, Loco will die to Edism, though. No, he will actually die to the Phoenix. Firebird's killing him. Haxor getting on Egoism. Nice Shackle there, and it's a dead Egoism.
Yeah. Really turning it around. Wow, I wouldn't say they're turning it around. I think it's just really even right now.
Yeah, it's the gold swings aren't huge. I'm going to check net worth quickly. Net worth graph, it's slightly going the way of Grino, but only slightly. 1,500, it's very recoverable.
Yeah, still anyone's game.
Still anyone's game. Let us check then. Cola Light doesn't really have much in terms of items, but he doesn't need any.
No, I reckon he's just going to go for the Aghanim's Rush right now.
Nah, probably. Probably get some Arcanes along the way. Maybe just skip the Arcanes entirely.
you might not even want to.
Fail, meanwhile, is trying to fight up against Loco. I believe he's going to go early fighting here.
Yeah, I think I agree there as well.
Mm-hmm.
I think early fighting would be the best bet.
I mean, just the pure Desolate damage you get there. 65 bonus damage, it's really good.
Yes, like, Spectre could be one of the best
solo. Ooh, Haunts! Cola Light actually might take a fall here. He definitely will take a fall here.
Wolverate on top. Wolverate. Oh my god, he turned that around.
Unfortunately, I was watching the bot lane, where Eduism is about to eat it.
Eat it indeed.
Wolverape apparently managing to turn it around on the top lane against his Spectre gank. He did have someone in tow, and that was the Phoenix. Loco now going up against Residu and Zut again. Residu and Zut is not able to get anything done. He's going Yules, but that's... yeah, it's actually pretty close to his Yules. He just needs the staff, and that's it, I believe.
Yeah, and there's a Sol Ring on the Rubick. I don't really see this often. Like, I played Earthshaker with the Tranquil Boots and Sol Ring, but never with the Rubick.
I think it's a good combo if you really don't need the Arcanes, and if you know someone else is going to be building mech, or you just don't need a mech.
Yeah, that's also a good point there.
I mean, you usually get the Arcane Boots if you're going to be building either... Now, nowadays, you get them because you either need the mana or you want to be building into... what's it called? Into Guardian's Grease. Thing is, though, it's like... who's a natural mech builder on Rhino's team?
Natural mech builder on Rhino... Silencer, AA, and Rubick could get one, but I reckon that Rubick and AA have got better things to do than get that item.
Yeah. Ags on AA, Ags on Rubick, both are really good. Silencer is actually just building straight into an Ags right now.
I think Ags Rush is a lot better.
Mm. So we probably won't be seeing any mechs from Rhino, which is okay.
I guess so, yeah. They have a lot of the early damage output as well, so I don't think mech's too important. And on the side of Honeymen, you don't really want to get a mech because they have AA, so
yeah,
it's a waste of money.
What's it going to be worth for?
Yeah, it's not going to be worth a lot.
Okay, aggressive, probably a scouting ult there. Where will Spectre Hunt into? She will actually kill the Windranger, who was on the back line. She's using the ultimate Spectre voice pack, which, in my opinion, is not the best. And there's the Ice Blast going to hit Eduism, pretty sure. Wow, that's a lot of damage on Eduism.
Oh,
and Eduism will die.
Eduism dies to the... yeah, there we go. The penis didn't even have to get him.
Oh dear.
Hmm.
There we go.
Quite slower. It's getting a bit slower now. There's less kills going on.
Yep, no, actually, like...
not a lot of action.
Not really. We can check the net worth, and it's been... in these last 4 minutes, we have really not had many kills. It's 4,000 net worth for Rhino Gaming. It's dipping down again for their favour, so... recoverable.
Recoverable.
Recoverable. Honig Mana just need to play their cards right.
Yeah, it's far from non-consensual yet.
It's not even bad yet, really. I mean, you can play from behind. Problem is, Spectre is probably the only exception here. She can't really play from behind as well as other people can.
Yeah, I definitely agree with you there, for the reason that without having much farm at the start of the game, Spectre doesn't really get more. Like, she farms heroes.
She has to farm heroes, yeah.
Yeah, she sort of just farms heroes, really.
I mean, unless she has a Radiance, which she is saving up for right now, but you want that before, like, 25 minutes, 30 minutes.
Yeah, that's... I think it's 20 minutes, really, at pro standard.
Pro standard, you got a point there. And Eduism is going to eat another Ice Blast, and is probably going to die again from the Ice Blast. Will Residu and Zut be the next one to fall, though? Cooldown will hit him twice. Yes, he will. Actually, Loco is going to have a problem. He has to Global Silence to make sure he doesn't die from Witch Doctor Ult. It's going to save him, though. And he will return to base. 3 kills on the mid lane.
Yeah. Well played by them.
Good on them.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, Akos is waiting for an opportunity on the bot lane. Has not leveled Focus Fire. It just took a level on Focus Fire, actually.
Yeah, he's there's no point in getting it too early because his spells do a lot more damage and give you a lot more survivability. And he's quite far off the Aghanim Scepter anyway.
Yeah.
1,800 gold away, so he's not going to be getting that anytime soon.
Mm. He just needs a bit.
Yeah, just a bit.
I feel like he's playing, like, slightly, very conservatively for Windrunner, though.
Yeah, like, he's...
Ooh, LC. Ooh, that's a nice shackle, and that's gonna kill the Phoenix. Phoenix killing Windranger, but will it kill the Spectre is the question. Ooh, it might... It might, no. No, just not there.
Don't you know I'm loco? Nah, he didn't go in. I thought he would. Zeus is just giving out the harassment.
He's just waiting because he just needs 100 more gold. He just needs 100 more gold. Then he's got his, Haunt into the Spectra. But there's an immediate TP reaction. And Spectra's gonna get hit by Ice Blast. Killing off Silencer but dying in return. And now they're just gonna push in mid.
Yep, they need to start getting some powers down the Radiant side because they don't really have natural pushers. And pushing into the Dire team late game, I wouldn't want to do that.
Nah, not really.
They have a Fade Bolt, they have Ice Blast, they have Gyrocopter, cooldown, Flat Cannon. I don't think that you're going to be walking high ground anytime soon.
Unless you pick up a good Aegis and get some a few good, you know, ganks off, let's put it that way.
I think Pipe and AC. That's gonna be it. Those are gonna be the two items that help them breach high ground. I think Spectre will get that Radiance and then probably prioritize a Scardy Diffusal Blade and then maybe that AC late game.
Sounds like a good idea. Meanwhile, I'm just looking at Dire ward coverage. That's a lot of ward coverage.
Yeah, they've been keeping a few wards in their own infantries and on the courier. I was gonna say it but I forgot about it earlier. But this is what they do, they sort of like flash out loads of wards everywhere, cost way too much money to buy so many sentries. Oh, Ice Blast bottom.
Kylo Light gets hauled, he will not be, Silence is good! Meaning, actually, they're gonna get a double kill, they might even get a triple kill, Edoism is not running the right direction. Fish is up, but he's already dead, and he knows it.
As Hacksaw said at the start of the game, karma.
Karma. Very true. That silence is very good. That's 1,800 gold swing for Rhino.
Yeah, I do wisdom at the start of the game for Easy Fisher and then Hacksaw just wrote Karma, so what goes around comes around, I guess.
Yeah, there you go. that's good. They're just easily going to take this tower, eh?
Yeah, they're just going to smack it down. They've got Focus Fire up on Arkosh, he's just going to punch it in the face. Yeah, Windranger, definitely a derpy ginger. Morality, tell me, do you like gingers?
You know, yes.
Yes, I like gingers. Okay. Yeah, gingers are good, gingers are good.
They don't have the soul of the devil, or whatever you say.
Oh,
Aghanim's,
no.
Aghanim's is actually up on Silencer.
Oh, that's really good. That's such a good timing. Well, he did skip the tier 2 boots. Now he just gets a refresher orb and say goodbye to the whole of the Radiant team's mana. It's so OP.
There you go. Silencer, very good counter pick in this case.
Yeah, and also it stops channeled abilities even with a BKB. The Witch Doctor's going to struggle. Radiant's mid tower.
Nice ult there. Excuse me for a second, people. I seem to be having some issues. Quickly, I will be right back. Zach, keep talking.
I shall keep talking. And if we have a look at the net worth right now, I don't think you can see it because Lucas is the camera guy. We have a Gyrocopter on top right now, and he's purchased a new Sanjin Yasha with the Helm of the Dominator on top at 20 minutes in. He's definitely doing really well. We have Thail now pushing in the mid tower with Phoenix backing him up with the laser beam. Hacksaw has a stolen cast, has picked him up. The ice blast is coming in. It hits Thail. The cooldown's down and it's totally whiffed. And then the fire spirits are stolen by Hacksaw and nothing else happens. Oh, there's a Fisher from Edoism and it's been whiffed. Yeah, and that was a 1-0 trade on their carry Spectre. So it's looking really well for the side of Rhino right now. They've taken out three towers. Oh, here we go. Some drawings on the map. Hacksaw takes Fisher. That's a really good spell to take on Rubick with that zero cast animation time. Yeah, there's a few sentry wards up now in the Radiant Jungle from the Dire side, blocking out all potential farming attempts from the Radiant. I think they've realised that Spectre's trying to get that Radiant, so they are really punishing him right now by making sure they focus on him a lot. Also, there's been a very prevalent thing in this game. Spectre's been playing really aggressive, and playing aggressive is not how Spectre's farm at all. Like, the kills? Yeah, maybe, but keeps getting shackled shot, and with that ice blast coming in afterwards, Spectre just does not have the HP pool to deal with it. And even the Zeus early game, the Witch Doctor barely has 1,000 HP. Even the Earthshaker has 1,000 HP. They've all been. Oh, there's a Thunder God's Raft. Spectre, there's an ice blast coming in, telekinesis, and he dies again. He's playing very aggressive, and it's just not paying off for him. Okay, and now on the bot lane we have Rhino Arkosh. He's trying to TP out, and oh, stop with the Yule Scepter. And the lightning bolt would be coming down. Chain lightning. Can Arkosh get away? No, the arc lightning comes through. Quite unfortunate. Ooh, there's a. The Helm of the Dominated Wild Wing Ripper. I think that's a stack of the Ancients. Yeah, there's a few Ancient stacks now for the Dire side. I reckon that the Gyrocopter will be picking that one up later and probably getting a load of farm. Yeah, they're going to stack that again. There's a Bounty Rune on the Ancient Apparition. Ancient Apparition is 2/3 of the way through the Aghanim Scepter with 700 gold. And we keep looking around right now. We're looking at Cola Light. He's got that point booster towards his Shaganim Scepter. Oh, Cola Light's been hit with the Ice Blast, and I think Cola Light's going to take a fall here. No, Cola Light lives. Survives. Well played indeed.
Unfortunately, I am so sorry. Unfortunately, my mic was starting to show some issues. So I had to resolve that. Anyway, back to casting. Anything happened interesting while I was gone?
No, just a few kills on the supports, that's all, and a few items picked up on the support site.
We have a look quickly. Yes, Zeus has his... Spectra has her sacred relic, so...
Yeah, she's had it for quite a while, but she's been playing really aggressive, and it's... Not
paying off.
No, not paying off at all.
Okay, blink up on Rubick, that's important.
Especially with spells to steal like Echo Slam, Blink Dagger's really good.
Another thing to notice that Gyro now is a Sanjin Yasha, so...
Yeah, and he's just taken a massive Ancient stack.
Just straight up buying an Ultimate Orb and has 1,500 left over, that's pretty good.
Yeah, it was about 5 or 6 creeps stacked up there. Literally just got a massive inflation of gold then.
Pretty good. Let's have a look at the net worth. It's 10,000 for Rhino, so it's starting to turn non-consensual.
Yeah, I think the point of no return is 15,000. That is the non-consensual point.
Although, yesterday, the team that had 15,000, they were playing against the Swiss Incredible Rebels. 15,000, and yes, Sir was able to come back a few times, but were lost it again at team fights they held afterwards. XP is also looking pretty good. Yeah.
Nice. He had the Blink Dagger. Oh, it's a 25-minute Radiance on the Spectre, plus the Phase and Magic Wand. It's not the fastest time he could have got one, but nonetheless, it's still in time, sort of.
Considering he's 5'8", I'm going to say that's actually pretty good.
Yeah, I think so. And he's the leading farmer on his own team as well. When the Aghanim Scepter's up on the Ancient Apparition, it's going to be really scary.
Oh yeah, that's 17 seconds of freeze.
Yeah, What's it called? Frostbite.
Ice Blast, yeah, Frostbite, I believe.
Yeah, Frostbitten, yeah. Well, the only way you can really deal with the Frostbitten thing is getting a pipe, and no one is looking for a pipe right now.
Yeah, Residu and Zatsis, in fact, oh, what a shackle! This is gonna kill LC if he doesn't get his egg off in time. In fact, he's silenced, so he will never get his egg off. He's dead. That's two kills.
Yeah, well played indeed.
That last word is really powerful against, what's it called? Well, against Phoenix. Because the second he presses Icarus Dive, he's coming right back.
Oh yeah, he just came right back. He was just like, oh shit. It was at this moment, Phoenix knew.
He had fucked up.
Fucked up. Yeah, this is like one of the first games today we've actually seen Gyrocopter on like the winning side.
Yeah.
That's safe to say.
It's like he's mostly been at a loss, even though it's mostly the team just based around him. Spectra, let's see if they will get Spectra here. They know where he is. He's just gonna haunt away though. Silence is up. Where did Spectra haunt though? Ah, there he is. And now Loco seems to be in a bit of trouble. He's on his own, and they're gonna just secure the kill with Fandegod's Wrath.
Yeah. That was well played. Oh, Spectre gets the kill.
Spectre actually just getting hit by the so-called penis.
Yeah. The Skadi on
Ooh, that's deadly.
That's deadly indeed. Dire's top tower, you know the drill. Alright, so Edoism for the Fissure. And Fimo.
Stolen Fissure! Nice, here comes the cooldown! Killing Residu and Zats and LC and I believe Zeus, yeah. Vale is now the next one to fall. Focus Fire dealing all that damage. Haxel will fall though. Cola Light doing so much damage with the Death War. Ultra kill for Wolverine though.
Oh god. That was unfortunate.
Very unfortunate. Wolverine. Stop it,
please. It's not consensual.
Oh my god.
He just got 2,300 gold just by killing the whole team.
Spectre has actually managed to catch up on net worth. He's above a silencer, but still, Spectre is one of those heroes who needs more gold than everyone else to be even ahead, you know, to be even on the same level, same page.
Oh yeah, and I think that Spectre scales the best with farm out of every hero in the whole of Dota.
That's why she's so good late game.
Oh yeah, of course, especially when you get the refresher orb and you put it in your stash, you use Haunt, and then you put it back out your stash, that's the best bit. And you're like, essentially 8 slotted.
Yeah, because you've also got then, imagine you have an Alchemist on the same team, you get the Aghanims up, you get the Aghanims from him. Yeah, because reason. Everything. Get the Aghanims, you start stacking Moon Shards.
Oh yeah, that's the best that is. That's good old Dota.
Like 10 slotted Spectre, great.
10 slotted Spectre, best Spectre. Alright, let's see what happens. I think that.
Wolverine is in a bit of trouble here. He's going to have to use cooldown defensively. He will get a kill on the Earthshaker and the Zeus and.
What do you mean he's in trouble? He's not in trouble.
Oh,
he's fine.
The fight doesn't go to him, he goes to the fight.
Yeah.
Axe actually managing to pick up a kill on the Phoenix as well. Good, yeah. Good change there. Good gold change there. 2,000-3,000 Rhino about. Let's have a look. It's about 15,000, 20,000 Rhino net worth. 20,000 XP, and Fail is going to end up dead here. There she goes. And where is Gyro? Actually, back at base, wants to regen up the mana. But for now, the tier 3 will fall.
Oh, yeah. Oh, that is so dirty.
Oh, what an Echo Slam! What a Fissure! What a combo! Arkosh has to run, and Cola Light getting a double kill. Now, Arkosh has to run, but he will get killed by Zeus. 4 kills. Wow, what a gold swing. Holy.
Okay. I think that the Dire team right now are reflecting on what just happened.
You should not have done that.
Karma. Witch Doctor has his acronyms now.
Because you know Hagrid in Harry Potter, like 1 and 2, it's like, I should not have said that, I should not have said that. Instead, replace said with done. I should not have done that, I should not have done that.
Yeah. They definitely messed up then.
They didn't notice that Echo Slam has been off cooldown for the entirety of this time.
Yeah, and if you have a look at Earthshaker's gold. What the hell happened there?
Holy crap. I have to see. Who did he kill to get that much gold? Yeah, he killed Loco. Yeah, probably. Yeah, that's that. 700 gold only from Loco.
Oh, yeah. How's that refresher orb coming along? He's bought the recipe, so he's not far off indeed.
Tower has been denied.
Oh, yeah.
Spectra is getting a BKB. Now they will just start taking Rosh, though. Even though that fight was amazing, I don't think they have enough to contest this Rosh. And net worth is still around 15,000.
Yeah, they're not even sure that they're doing Rosh. Oh wait, maybe they are. Maybe they are getting a suspicion right now. But the Dire Wards are scouting them all out.
Alright, we'll pick up the Aegis.
Yeah, he can just walk high ground now and just pew-pew at the barracks.
Pew. Yes. Good old pew-pew tactics.
Yeah, fack cannon. Then we got the cold beats off AA.
Cold beats.
Oh, Arkosh has found Fail.
But, isn't it, or is it the other way around? Has Fail found Arkosh? No.
I think so. Oh, the power shot from downtown. Oh, wasn't far enough.
Oh, there's Gyro being a bit overconfident here. Death Ward is out. In fact, they're going to kill him. But he has Aegis, so he got 2 kills and they'd already just popped Aegis. Great.
Yeah. I think they could just walk up high ground now.
In fact, you know what's funny? He could just straight up buy a butterfly right now.
Yeah, like he really just could. He might... Oh, he's going to buy it, yeah. Bought the core stack.
I'm literally saying he could walk up to the secret shop. Imagine like just from base buying an entire butterfly just like that.
This is
Oh, there, Hacksaw. The stolen fish are best spell.
That's a non-consensual now.
There goes Zeus. And now there's another cooldown, probably just to zone out here.
Yeah.
In fact, most buybacks Sobirai will back off having bought his butterfly.
What a wonderful day to cast some Dota. And the teams are playing very well.
There's his pension, eh?
Yeah. Here's my pension. You even know I'm Loco, he's on a regen rune right now. And I cannot pronounce Zeus's name. Let's have a go.
Residu and Zuts gets blocked off and Yulzed and non-consensually Ice Blast.
Ow. Yeah, he's done for.
There you go.
There you go.
Not much to say, really. There's a smoke coming up from these three here. Gyro probably going to be acting as bait here.
Yeah, I think he's baiting here.
Ooh, he sees us Fail or Fail sees him. Either way, it's going to end up in a bit of an engagement. Cooldown used, but not to its full extent. Edoism is actually buying a Shiva's Guard or something with this, with a Mystic Star. But anyway, Hacksaw jumps in and will immediately get bursted down. But here comes the rest of Team Radiant. And they're just going to start killing the egg. But Witch Doctor's on the back lines. However, nice Shackle keeping the damage from doing too much. Only Ancient Apparition will end up fully dead here.
Yeah, it's quite unfortunate because that was a really good fight.
And that was that. Witch Doctor coming back in to do whatever he can.
Radiant's top tower.
Yeah, but it's not going to happen.
Maybe the GG cool now.
There goes the Rex, and Gyro is on a roll, really.
Yeah. I think it's all over now. They're going to be cleaning up the Rex.
Oh, that was nice timing on the call there.
Oh, yeah.
He will... Ooh, nice cast bounce, but unfortunately, not even the Thunder God's Wrath was enough. Well, that was enough. Whoa! Whoa! What? How much gold? 2,171.
What? That's a lot of money.
I just want to write an old chat right now, just saying what.
I'll do it for you. That's a 2k gold? Really? Wolverine is I'm speechless, like he was rich.
Of course, I mean net worth is 23,000. Holy crap.
He's double the Spectre. Like near enough, he's double the Spectre.
Let's see, will that make a difference though? It's gonna give Of course it's gonna give Zeus a full ags.
Yeah, if he wanted one. I think the buyback is probably the most important thing right now on his mind.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, probably. Thing is, 25,000 net worth change for Rhino, it's not gonna make much of a difference even though they killed the Gyro. Yeah, Gyro's actually just reached level cap, so we're probably gonna see some XP drop offs right now.
Yeah, did he just hit level 25?
Not really. I believe he hit it around... If you look at the XP graph, around that small peak towards Rhino there.
Yeah, no one else in the game is near 25.
Silence. Global silence. Silence actually killed Spectre there. Probably on the top lane. Oh, what is Ancient Apparition doing? Running around in the enemy jungle.
Dying.
Gyro is going full on global presence right now. Got to have some bots.
Yeah, bots and Aghanims, that's always pretty fun. I've never actually purchased Aghanims Gyro, I'm going to try it sometime.
I heard it's very fun.
Yeah, with the global cooldown, that's always fun.
Like, I'm just going to call you down whenever you want. Hey, my team needs some support. Anyways, I'm getting hit by the rocket. Walks out of the base and immediately gets hit by a rocket. Looks like Wolverine could be in a bit of trouble here. Remember, he's level 25. Not good Fisher. Haxel stealing Fisher instead. And now the refresher silence is coming in here. There goes the Fisher blocking his own self. Force staffing forward though to make sure that Wolverine can keep going on his rampage. Cola Light does get a cask off, but it's not going to help.
No.
Satanic should be. Like, if he had a Satanic, he probably wouldn't even care right now. He'd just walk in there.
Yeah.
Rax are tier 2 down, tier 3 down, second set of Rax going in. Fimo has actually purchased bots as well. Wolverine actually getting some good casks off here. In fact, those casks were incredibly good. Wolverine is actually going to die to the Radiance damage here.
Zeus gets more gold.
Zeus is feeding himself up on Wolverine. He's actually purchased his own BKB now.
Oh, top lane Arkosh coming in.
Meanwhile, Arkosh is just pushing top. Yeah, you got a point there. Zeus, meanwhile, is fighting it up against Fimo. Residuan's that's going to get hit by the Ice Blast, which means he's frostbitten. Will he be able to kill our Sino before? Yes, he will, but Fimo, Haxel will get the kill. Meanwhile, Windrager is TPing out.
Yeah,
and Gyro did buy back there.
Right, they need the Dream Echo Slam right now.
Thing is, is it going to happen?
If all the creeps ganged around, probably.
And here we go. Edoism's probably going to end up dead here. Edoism is very dead. Is LC very dead? No. LC is actually cold-feeted up here. Will he be frozen? He will not be frozen. Haunt in onto Fimo. But the Frostbite is there. And Fimo will fall. Egg is popped.
What does that mean?
But you know what? It's over. There goes the third set of racks. And LC will be the next one to fall, most likely. Will he be the last one to fall is the question. reported shit talking going on once again between the two teams.
Oh yeah, it's just a bit of fun now, isn't it?
I mean, it's over.
It's over now. Quite unfortunate because both teams played really well. Well, the Radiant played really, really well from behind.
They did. Let's look at net worth, and it's really non-contextual right now. Silence is out, and what is Fail doing? Hey, he's just going on hacks. All right, now this is over though. Will Fail die? No. What an Echo Slam! Oh. Actually, getting Wolverine. Ooh, what is this? The comeback, is it real?
The comeback's on.
Ah, no. The physical damage is there from Witched off the roll, but he has the magical spell called Dying.
And meanwhile, in the Radiant base. Oh no, big ice blast from downtown.
Oh, there's Haxor and there's Fimo and...
Yeah, they're gonna start ticking out now.
Residuo and Zatsu will probably be the next one to die. No, he actually saves himself with the Yules. But it's not gonna happen.
Oh no, he still dies.
GG, well played. The Ancient will explode.
That's it.
And that would be 1-0 for Rhino Gaming. No, 2-0 for Rhino Gaming? 1-0.
1-0.
1-0 for Rhino Gaming.
And we're starting the next game promptly, right?
Pretty soon. So please stay tuned for game 2 of this best of 3 series. The winner of this match will go to the preliminary finals against the Wasted Talents. Until then, I was Morality Clause.